Now, we are scouring the country as we speak to find local bowling legends. And we're doing that with thanks to Apia, whose dedicated specialists are ready to help. You can give them a call on 13 50 50. What makes this sport so unique is the stories, not just from international level, but all the way down to grassroots level. And we have another fantastic story for you today.
Innisfail Bowls Club has really become a social centre for the town. It's a very humble club. People of all ages can come here.
Innisfail's just, I think it's built differently. Like, everyone's got such like a family feeling everywhere. Like, everyone's friends, and I think I've become a part of that now.
Innisfail, we don't have a lot of social aspects to the town. The club is almost 100 years old. And so a lot of work has gone in there from previous people, and I know Alf's dedicated so much in the last 6 years to it that he's proving his point that it's the place to be.
My name is Alf, and I've been playing bowls maybe 20, 30 years, more serious in the last 6 years since I've become president.
Alf's been a great president in relation to any matters to do with bowls.
With the embankment, we've had issues there for years, maybe 70, 80 years. It's slowly collapsing into the river.
The situation has become critical. The assertion was one more flood and the Bowls Club will be gone.
We've reignited the issue of trying to get funding to repair the bank, and we finally, after 40, 50, 60 years, have got it happening. As we speak, it's happening there now. About 6 years ago, the club wasn't travelling too well, so we decided to point the club in a different direction, and we started involving backpackers who had nowhere to go around town. And from then on, we've just become the place to go, with some fantastic nights we've had here, with fancy dress, karaoke.
The backpackers love seeing the outback. You know, that when they come to town or go to small towns for regional work, they don't see a lot of the countryside. So Al's been doing that for I don't know how many years. You know, he just loves organising things.
We just want them to experience a bit of the Australian outback. There's bull riding, there's horse races, we play card games, we play beer pong. I'm still the champion at beer pong, so after 3 years, yeah. So that's pretty proud of that too.
Alf comes from a family that's very well known in Innisfail. People with business and cane farms.
It's a family farm that's been handed down over the three generations now. And yeah, we started off with a couple of hundred acres. We're down to about 60 acres now. And there's no money in it. It's just more therapeutic and somewhere where I can sing a song on a tractor. I'm only a tractor singer. I'm not even a shower singer. I haven't got the best voice. If no one can hear me, I'll have a go, but if someone's there, forget it.
He is hospitality personified, both in relation to food and generosity.
Run out of things to cook for tonight? Well, what better time to teach your kids how to eat broccoli?
He's a born cook like his dad was, always tried something different. His favourite, I'd say, pasta lenticchia. Pasta with split peas and lentils. Beautiful. The best.
In Italian, split peas is specelli secchi spezzati.
Si, specelli secchi spezzati. But in Sicilian, we call it split the pizza.
My son happened to send me a recipe that had 30 ingredients. So I sent one back to him with 5. And I said, this is how you cook the Italian way. Keep it simple. And that's how, with the girl, Natalie, that's staying with us, she was doing all the camera work and doing the editing and all that. And that's how all that started. And then I was getting calls on Facebook and ringing up, when's the next show? When's the next show? So we ended up doing five or six every Tuesday.
Oh, man.
I was shocked. Yeah, a lot of response. And I don't class myself as a cook, but very far from it. But it became pretty funny.
Alf is always lining us up to do the cooking here, so We might have to do something about that.
Till we meet again, stay safe. Ciao.